State College, Pennsylvania. Ohio State's dynamic passing offense, ranked number 6 in the country coming into Saturday's game at Penn State, bubble and tunnel screened for its life with its back against the wall in front of the biggest crowd in the history of Beaver Stadium on Saturday night. Those 110,889 people watched Buckeyes receiver KJ Hill take a screen and high-step his way into the end zone for a game-winning 24-yard touchdown with 2:03 left, erasing what was a two-score Penn State lead and sending Ohio State to a 27-26 win. Make that 2 years in a row that the Buckeyes have beat the Nittany Lions by a point. Ohio State defensive end Chase Young capped the win, stopping running back Miles Sanders for a 2-yard loss on 4th and 5 with 1:16 left to thwart and an attempt at a game-winning drive. The play call was confusing given the rushing success of Penn State quarterback Trace McSorley, but after Penn State called 2 timeouts and the Buckeyes called 1, that's what the Lions settled on. The win puts number 4 Ohio State, 5-0-2-0 Big Ten, in the driver's seat for the Big Ten East Division race with 2 months of season left, and leaves Penn State, 4-1-1-1, needing wins the rest of the way, and then probably still some help, if it wants to stay in the college football playoff hunt. The Buckeyes trailed 26-14 in the fourth quarter when quarterback Dwayne Haskins stepped up in the pocket and floated a ball down the middle of the field for receiver Ben Victor. Victor wrestled the ball away from a defender, then ran for a 47-yard score to make it 26-21 with 6:42 left. Hill's score then capped an 8-play, 96-yard drive that gave the Buckeyes the lead for good. Ohio State's defense, put in a position to defend a 1-point lead late against Penn State for the second straight year, came through again. Young sacked McSorley on 2nd down, and made the game-sealing play on 4th down. Young had 6 tackles, 3 for loss, 2 sacks and 2 pass breakups in the best game of his career. The OSU defense was again bit by big plays, allowing Penn State to rack up a program record 492 total offensive yards. McSorley rushed for 174, the most for a Penn State quarterback since 1938, but the Buckeyes made plays that kept OSU in the game early, and stood up late. That was big on the night when Ohio State had trouble breaking through offensively. Haskins and the offensive line had trouble handling pressure early, and things didn't open up until the screen game became more of a feature in the second half. Haskins finished 22 of 39 for 270 yards, 3 touchdowns and an interception. Ohio State took its first lead when running back J.K. Dobbins capped a 13-play, 75-yard drive with a 4-yard run early in the third quarter. The Buckeyes, undone by Penn State's pressure in the first half, started to negate it with a quick passing game that led to that score and put them in position for another late in the third quarter. But Sean Neuernberger's made field goal was called back on a face mask penalty on tight end Luke Farrell. Neuernberger then missed from 48 yards to keep OSU's lead at 14-13 with 6:12 left. Penn State missed its own chance for points when, within range for a 41-yard field goal, it opted to go for it on 4th and 1. Young batted McSorley's pass out of the air and ended the drive. That was a part of a big night for Young, who stepped up with Ohio State missing Nick Bosa. Ohio State's defensive line had a strong night in general, but the big play remains a struggle. That was true on Penn State's first touchdown, a 93-yard pass play in the first quarter, and on the second, when a 36-yard completion to KJ Hamler coupled with a targeting penalty on OSU safety Isaiah Pryor put Penn State in position for a 2-yard pass from McSorley to tight end Pat Freiermuth for a 2014 lead with 12:22 left. Penn State took a 26-14 lead when back-to-back McSorley runs set up a 1-yard touchdown run by Sanders. Ohio State's worst offensive start. Perhaps the Buckeyes felt good about being down just 13-7 when the game entered halftime. Based off the numbers, you might have assumed much worse. Penn State outgained Ohio State 293-93 in the first 2 quarters, and held the ball for just over 18 minutes. That made the evaluation of OSU's defense a bit difficult. What can you say about a defense that holds the country's number one scoring offense to 13 points despite giving up nearly 300 yards, limited it to 1 TD in 10 possessions, but also gave up a 93-yard touchdown on a total breakdown when Hamler ran untouched through the middle of the field after catching a slant? Again, the defense was bit by a big play, but thanks to some otherwise solid play, and questionable play calling by Penn State that got a little too cute, Ohio State was within a score of the half. The defense set up Ohio State's only real scoring opportunity in the first half. Linebacker Tuff Borland forced a fumble that was recovered by Dre Montana Jones at the Penn State 25. Two plays later, running back J.K. Dobbins scored on a screen pass from Haskins. The Buckeye offense was inefficient in the first half, struggling with pass protection while Haskins completed 7 of 16 passes, and averaging 3.1 yards per play while struggling to sustain drives and punting 7 times. But when gifted good field position by the defense, Ohio State finally did something to get within a touchdown before the break.
Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and activate the bell button.